Unchangeable, forever the same. As old as you are, cultures are changing, nations are changing, traditions are changing, but you are still the same. That is why you are faithful. That is why you are reliable. The rock of ages, I am is your name. We bless you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Glory fills the heaven and all the earth. Your glory fills all the earth. The seas, to the mountains, to the valleys, from continent to continent. Your glory is all over. We see it manifesting in your creation. Wherever the sun is, God, you are there. You fill the entire earth with your glory. We thank you for your glory in our midst. We thank you, O Lord. Continue to be with us. We cannot survive without your glory. We cannot live without your glory. We cannot exist without your glory. We need your glory, O Lord. Restore unto us the joy of your presence that comes from your glory. Lord, as your word is coming, prepare us. Spirit of the living God, grant us understanding, the grace to apply your word, that we will feel, experience, and walk in that glory. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. You may take your seat. Thank you, Lord. Jesus said in John chapter 16, verse 7, that it is for your good that I go to the Father. It is for your good that I go to the Father so that the Helper will come. Hallelujah. In other words, we cannot live this life to the full. We cannot accomplish much in this life without the Comforter, without the Helper, without the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So today we are going to look at power indescribable. Power indescribable. Power beyond description. Hallelujah. Power unspeakable. Power indescribable. That's what we are going to look at. Why Jesus told the disciples that it is for your good that I go, so that the Helper, who is comparable to me, will come to you. Amen. So we are going to look at power indescribable. So we're going to look at the first scripture, John 16, 7.
Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you.
Hallelujah. Nevertheless, I tell you that it is to your advantage that I go to the Father. It is to your advantage. It is for your good that I go to the Father so that the Helper will come. In other words, if you do not have the Holy Spirit, if you not have the baptism thereof, if you don't have the Spirit of God residing in you, then you are somehow disadvantaged. It is to your advantage. Hallelujah. So if you don't have him, then you are disadvantaged. Jesus knew the importance of you and I having the Holy Spirit in this dispensation. That we cannot achieve much, we cannot do much for the kingdom of God. We cannot advance the cause of this kingdom without the help of the Holy Spirit. The church cannot fulfill her destiny as a church of Jesus Christ, a body of Christ, doing what the church is supposed to do without the Holy Spirit. Therefore, any church that does not recognize this fact, any church that does not welcome the Holy Spirit, the fullness of the Spirit, the baptism of the Spirit, cannot, that church cannot fulfill the commission that is supposed to. Hallelujah. Jesus knew the importance of that. Why was he talking about that? Jesus knew that without the Spirit, we cannot even fulfill the purpose for which God has called you and I. Jesus himself, according to Luke chapter 2, verse 52, Jesus himself had to work with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. He was conceived of the Spirit. In his entire life and ministry, It was all about the Holy Spirit. Because he was in this world, he was in the same flesh as you and I are. And he understood that for him to accomplish the purpose of his coming to the earth, he needs the help of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Luke chapter 2, verse 52.
He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted the lowly. And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and men.
Hallelujah. I was wondering about the translation you were using. It said, Jesus grew in wisdom and in stature. Hallelujah. Now, this is talking about the Holy Spirit that was upon Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit that was with him. He grew in wisdom. And the wisdom here, we are talking about wisdom of God that has been imputed, that has been deposited in Jesus Christ. You remember, even at age 12, Bible says he could stand in front of the Pharisees and the Sadducees, the high priest and the scribes, and could lecture them as a professor emeritus. And they could not understand what he was teaching. He grew in wisdom and in stature because of the Spirit of God that was with him. Hallelujah. So, Jesus Christ, in his entire life, it was all about the Holy Spirit. From conception, through growth, the beginning of his ministry, and thereafter. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 3, verse 22.
And the Holy Spirit descended in bodily form, like a dove upon him. And a voice came from heaven, which said, You are my beloved son, in you I am well pleased.
Hallelujah. So when Jesus had grown to the stage where he was supposed to, start his ministry on earth, Bible says he went to John the Baptist to be baptized. And during the baptism, Bible says as he was coming out of the water, and then the Holy Spirit appeared in the form of a dove and descended upon him. And that tells me something, that the Holy Spirit baptism took place at that time. Endorsement of the Holy Spirit of his commission. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit came upon Jesus Christ. So church, we need the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. If we can fulfill the purpose of our calling. Chapter 4, verse 18.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty who are oppressed.
Hallelujah. Now, in chapter 3, verse 22, we are talking about the baptism or the endorsement of the Holy Spirit. That is the commission of Jesus Christ, his purpose, his destiny here on earth. Now, in chapter 4, Jesus is talking about the fact that the Spirit of God is upon me, and he has commissioned me to do these things as he mentioned. Hallelujah. Now that the Spirit of God has come upon me, the baptism has taken place. Now this is what I am supposed to do. And here he was making reference to the prophecy of Isaiah, what Jesus was supposed to do. So without the Spirit of God coming upon him, Jesus could not have started this commission. We cannot do the extraordinary without the help of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God is upon me. Look, when you go through the Old Testament to the New Testament, the Holy Spirit has always been the one that anoints people, commission people into office. His ministry or his work did not just start with the New Testament era in Acts chapter 2 after the Pentecost experience. No, in the Old Testament, any man or woman of God who rose to the height as far as the spirit is concerned, those who achieved extraordinary feat in their ministry and in their lives, all of them were anointed by the Holy Spirit. And I can cite about 16 of them, characters in the Bible, that every one of them, it is the Spirit of God that came upon them before they could do what they were doing. Hallelujah. It is very important we recognize this. With this body you and I have, with this carnality, we cannot do certain things without the Spirit of God coming upon us. It is the Spirit that comes to quicken our mortal bodies to do what we could not have done before. Hallelujah. So without the help and the baptism of the Holy Spirit, we cannot do much for the kingdom. It is very important. We need to go back to the basics. We need to go back as Pentecostal to our root. It is very important that the Holy Ghost baptism, we need to welcome the Holy Spirit to come and fill his church so that we'll begin to do what the church fathers, the apostles did. Hallelujah. Now, if we go through the Old Testament, we can see that none of them was able to fulfill his or her destiny without the help of the Holy Spirit. We can look at Genesis chapter 1, verse 38. Genesis 1, 38. We're talking about Joseph here. Genesis chapter 41, verse 38.
And Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find such a one as this, a man in whom is the Spirit of God?"
A man in whom is the Spirit of God. You know, Pharaoh was a spiritual person. He had all these astrologers. He had all those who are into enchantment, divination, and all those guys were around him. You remember when, you know, Moses went there and then put down the rod and it turned into snake. His magicians also did the same thing. So he understood the things of the spirit. But then after observing this boy and his ability to be able to interpret dreams that even the magicians and astrologers could not interpret, though they could interpret times and seasons and all kinds of things, but this one, it was beyond their capability, beyond their talent. So he realized that, no, this is not an ordinary human spirit. Hallelujah. So the man who is hidden, an ungodly person, was able to come to that realization and conclude that, can we find a man in whom the Spirit of God is? In the whole land of Egypt, there is none except this boy. And the spirit that is upon him is not an ordinary spirit. Hallelujah. So we see clearly that this is not just Joseph himself by his experience or understanding. Or at that time, he was a young boy. Hallelujah. So the interpretation to the dream of Pharaoh was by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. So we need to welcome the Holy Spirit into our midst. We need to just open up to him, and then he will come and stay in us. And once he comes, he will help us to be able to do the things that we cannot do. Hallelujah. Now, let's look at Numbers chapter 11, verse 17. Numbers 11, 17. I'm just giving you a few instances from the Old Testament, because sometimes we think that the Holy Spirit started from Day of Pentecost in Acts chapter 2. No, the Holy Spirit has been there, just that they were in a different dispensation and the Holy Spirit was operating at a different level, was operating differently from this dispensation of grace.
"Then I will come down and talk with you there. I will take of the Spirit that is upon you and will put the same upon them. And they shall bear the burden of the people with you, that you may not bear it yourself alone."
Hallelujah. Now, here we still see the Holy Spirit at work in the life of Moses. There came a time that the work was becoming too much for him. Him alone. Moses was sat down from morning, listen to all the complaints, things that were happening in the camp, and they would come in their thousands. He would sit down till midnight. So, his father-in-law advised him to do something, put a structure in place to be able to handle this job. And the Bible says God gave him instruction. Call 70 elders from among you, from the people, and then I will come down, and the spirit that is upon you, that is where the key word is, the spirit that is upon you, that gives you the enablement to do what you are doing, I will take the same spirit and distribute it among you, and so that I will make sure I sync all of you together, so that there is no controversy, diversion, or division among you, because it's the same spirit that is upon you that I'm going to take and place upon all of them, so that you will be able to work in unity. Hallelujah. So we see the Spirit of God at work in the life of Moses. Hallelujah. Now, let's look at another example. Numbers chapter 27, verse 18. We need the Holy Spirit in our time. We need him more than ever.
And the Lord said to Moses, take Joshua the son of Nun with you, a man in whom is a spirit, and Hallelujah. Lay your hand on him.
A man in whom is the spirit, and lay your hand. You see, one thing we need to understand, that when we talk about Holy Spirit, baptism, we are not talking about the Spirit of God that you receive on the day of conversion. You come to the altar, you accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. We are talking about something completely different. Hallelujah. We are talking about the baptism, the fullness of the Spirit. Hallelujah. He says, take Joshua, in whom the Spirit of God is. He was the lieutenant at this time. He was the chief commander of the army of Moses. Whenever they went to war, he was the one that was leading them. The Spirit of God was upon him to be able to conquer his enemies. Hallelujah. And the enemies of Israel or the Jews. But yet, this time, God wanted an impartation to take place. And he made reference to the fact that the Spirit is already upon him. Hallelujah. So the Holy Spirit was at work in the life of Joshua as well. Let's look at Judges chapter 6, verse 34. Chapter 6, verse 34. But the Spirit of the Lord came upon Gideon. Then he blew the trumpet, and the Abiezrites gathered behind him. Hallelujah. This was the time that, you know, the Lord appeared in the form of an angel to him, and he said, oh, you son of Velo, mighty Velo, you are a man that I'm going to use to liberate my people. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And Bible says this guy became afraid. Said, God, I am from the least tribe among these people. In fact, I'm hiding in the bush. I'm trying to save some food, trying to hide them so that when the enemy come to destroy, at least I'll have something for myself and my family. So for you to tell me that I'm the one you are going to use to save the whole Israel, this is beyond me. And then God said, you are the one. The thing is in you, but you need the Spirit of God to come and quicken that body and take the fear away so that you will be able to realize your full potential. Hallelujah. You know, there are potential, powerful, great men and women of God sitting here. But, you know, it's just like the generator, the power engine. They are sitting there until they are started. They cannot produce energy. Hallelujah. That is how most believers we have become. It is the day that you receive that unction upon you. Then, Peter, who was scared of the damsel, becomes a Peter that can stand before the high priest and the lawyers and the governors and all that. That is what the baptism of the Holy Spirit can do. Hallelujah. And that is what you and I need. Bible says, this man received the Spirit of God came upon him, quickened his mortal body, took away the fear. And as soon as the Spirit came upon him and Gideon blew the trumpet, he got all the help and the support that he needed. Praise the Lord. Now confidence showed up. Boldness, courage came upon him. And he was able to accomplish the assignment that God gave unto him. Last but not the least, let's go to Judges chapter 14, verse 6.
And the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him. And he tore the lion apart as one who would have torn apart a young goat. Though he had nothing in his hand, but he did not tell his father or his mother what he had done.
Hallelujah. He had nothing in his hand. With his bare hands, Samson was able to do what? Tear the lion apart. It takes only the Holy Spirit to come upon you for you to tear the lions in your life apart. When the unction comes upon you, you are not afraid of anything. You can take anything, you can handle anything, you can bring down every mountain, you can destroy everything that needs to be destroyed. When the power comes upon you, it said, and the Holy Spirit came upon him mightily, mightily. So the doing, the killing and the tearing apart of the lion, it was not by his physical strength. It was the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. It is very important we acknowledge the work of the Holy Spirit in our life. It's unfortunate some are of the opinion that the work of the Holy Spirit ended with the apostles. It came only for the apostles. And after they completed the assignment, they were dead and gone, the Holy Spirit also stopped working. That is very unfortunate, and that is a heresy. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is still at work today, and it is about time we change our mindset about the Spirit. Amen? So, the point number one is that without the help of the Holy Spirit, we can never fulfill our destiny. We cannot. It is impossible. Hallelujah. Point number two, the Holy Spirit helps us to pray. The Holy Spirit helps us to pray. Praise the Lord. Romans chapter 8, verse 26 to 27.
Likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Now, he who searches the heart knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things
work. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 You see, there are times when you come to a place where uttering words or prayer becomes difficult for you. When you are troubled, distressed with issues of life, sometimes it becomes difficult even to pray. You remember Hannah. Here we are not talking about the fact that you don't pray. You make the move. You start praying. But when you get into that level of intensity where even words cannot come out of your mouth, Bible says that the Spirit that searches the heart knows the mind of God and knows your mind, and therefore knows exactly what you want to say to God. Just that it's not coming out the way it's supposed to. So the Spirit then comes in to intercede, interpret, say things that you cannot say verbally, says it to God. So all you are doing is you are just groaning from within, but the Spirit is doing the transmission. Hallelujah. You remember Hannah went into the temple, and Bible says that she was lying down and praying, and the way she was praying, she got to a point where the words were no longer coming. And the high priest, Eli, was sitting down and was looking, why are you drunk at this time? Take the alcohol away from the altar. Why are you doing that? In case you don't know, this is a shallow temple. So please, woman, if you have problems, don't come and drink and come and lie down here. We don't want that. And he said, no. my Lord, I am not drunk. There is something that has brought me here. And I am groaning and I'm travailing within my spirit. Bible says the woman's mouth was just open like that, but there was no words coming out. Amen. Then the Holy Spirit comes in and then intercede for her. Hallelujah. Because you see, without the help of the Holy Spirit, sometimes we are short of words. I'm not sure about you, but some of us, before we became baptized or we got baptized in the Holy Spirit, you pray and after some time you just got stuck because there are no more words to be spoken. Hallelujah. But when you have the Holy Spirit, as you are speaking with your mind and in your dialect, it gets to a point where as you run out of words, you switch gears. You move into the level of tongue speaking. So that is why we need the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit takes over your tongue, you can never stop. Amen. Praise the Lord. So the Holy Spirit helps us to pray. That is why those who are not baptized in the Spirit, they think that, what are you, everyday prayer, all the time prayer. In fact, when you are praying with them, before you realize, they're already snoring because they have finished. They are short of words. They have run out. Even praying over food, by the time you say amen, they're already middle of the food. They don't have, what is it that they have to say? Hallelujah. But when you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, he takes over when you stop. Hallelujah. When you cannot say further, the Holy Spirit takes over. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Holy Spirit also, another point, helps us to know the mind of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 10. The Holy Spirit helps us. We need the Holy Ghost baptism. It is very important.
But God has revealed them to us through his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God.
The Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. It is the Spirit that searches the deep things of God. Without the Spirit of God in you that connects you to the throne room of God, you can never know the mind of God concerning the issue. It is very important. It is when your spirit man is connected to the Spirit of God, that is where communication takes place and revelations come to you. You are able to interpret things differently because you hear from God. Verse 11.
For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah. So that is clear. The Spirit helps us to know the mind of God. Because nobody knows what is inside him or her except the spirit of that person. As I'm talking to you, I don't know what you are thinking. I don't know what is inside of you. I don't know your plans. It is you that know, and you know by your spirit. Hallelujah. So, for me to know what the Spirit is saying, I need to get connected to that Spirit. It is the Spirit of God that searches all things, reveals all things. So, with the help of the Holy Spirit, we receive revelation. And we receive the revelation of God and we respond by the understanding that we get from the Spirit. Hallelujah. So the spirit man responds to the Spirit of God. If we have the Spirit of God in us, we respond appropriately. If we don't have the Spirit of God, we interpret the things of God or the things of the Spirit differently. Because the carnal man cannot understand the things of God. Because the spirit is not regenerated. The spirit is not connected by the Spirit of God. So we interpret things differently until we become baptized with the Holy Spirit. Then we respond to the things of the Spirit in an appropriate manner as is expected of us as children of God. Hallelujah. So the Spirit of God becomes the conduit through which we connect and communicate with the Father. Hallelujah. When we have the Spirit of God, we're able to interpret the things of the Spirit the way it should. Now, the next point is that we receive empowerment for service. Empowerment. The Holy Spirit comes to empower us for service in ministry. It is very important. Acts chapter 1, verse 8.
But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth.
You shall receive power when the Holy Ghost baptism comes upon you and I. You will receive power, quickening, empowerment. It is dangerous to be a Christian without the Holy Spirit. You become vulnerable. You become powerless. You can carry the tag as a Christian, but there are certain battles you can never, you won't even survive it. So that is why Jesus said, it is to your advantage that I go to the Father. Because you need Holy Spirit. Because in this world, you will face persecution. You will be scandalized, and you will go through all kinds of things. What will help you to stand and survive is the power of the Holy Spirit. It is very important. Without that, church, many will give up in these days. It is the Holy Spirit that empowers us to stand. That when the going gets tough, because we have been toughened up by the Holy Spirit, we get going. John chapter 14, verse 12. John 14, 12.
Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me and the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than this he will do, because I go to my Father.
And greater works than this he will do. He that believes. Greater works than this. What are the works that Jesus came to do? Jesus came to preach the gospel. He came to teach. He came to heal the sick. He came to deliver the captive. Jesus started deliverance ministry. Read the scriptures well. He started deliverance ministry. Jesus only did not teach or preach, but he did deliverance. Jesus did healing, and some of the healings, you got to deal with the spirit that is behind. And when you read the gospel, it is there that most of the time, Jesus will have to cast out the demon first before healing would take place. And he said that you can do all these things. Jesus had to bring the dead to life. Lazarus and other people had to come back to life. Hallelujah. And he said you can do and even do more. But then, with what power are you going to do this? With which power are you going to do this? The Messiah himself had to wait, go through baptism, 40 days, night and day, fasting. And the Holy Spirit had to come upon him and commission him into ministry. So how can the church think for 1 minute that we can do without the Holy Spirit? It is impossible. How can you do without the Holy Spirit? Now, in Mark chapter 16, verse 18, let's read what has been committed to the church. Mark 16, 18.
They will take up serpents, and if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover.
Now, this is what Jesus was talking about. You will do more than I am doing. And as I'm sending you, these are the things that you will be able to do. You will preach the gospel, and those who will receive the gospel, those who accept, signs and wonders will follow you, and these are the things that you are going to do and all that. But then, what power are we going to use to do all these things? That is why he said in Acts chapter 1 and verse 4.
I've been assembled with them. He commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard from me.
He commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem. They should wait for for the Holy Spirit. And in verse 8, he says, and when the Spirit comes, the Spirit will give you the power, the ability, the enablement, the quickening, what it takes to be able to accomplish this commission. Wait for it. He commanded them. Now, look at the word, command. He issued command. In other words, he knew the challenges out there. He knew becoming a born-again Christian and live a life worthy of a believer, it is not an easy thing. Wait, you need the Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit. Wait. In fact, that term is a military term he used. He commanded them to wait. In other words, that word he issued is a military term and it demands obedience. Any attempt to ignore that commandment, you face the consequences. In other words, don't try it yet. Wait until you receive power. Jesus knew them. He knew their spiritual gravity, temperature. He knew that, look, the challenge out there is more than what you are thinking about. I have sent you more than twice to go and disciple. You came back with the good news that you have healed the sick and you have cast out demons. And yes, I know all the stories. But now I'm commissioning you into something greater. And you need a greater anointing. Because you cannot depend on yesterday's anointing, yesterday's power for tomorrow's challenge. Every day we need the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Don't rely on yesterday's grace and glory. You need something greater. Wait! It was a command. If you make an attempt and you step out without the Holy Spirit, you are in trouble. So any believer who thinks he can survive, make it without the Holy Spirit, it's not going to be easy. Hallelujah. Because our battles today, they are not flesh and blood. In the Old Testament, in the Old Dispensation, they fought the Amalekite and the Jebusite. They fought physical enemies. But in our dispensation, the Bible says, though we war, we fight. And our battle or our fight is not against flesh and blood. They are more spiritual. They are more spiritual. So we need to get spiritual. We should not feed on wine, but we should be filled with the Holy Spirit. We need that. We need that. Church, we need that. We need a baptism. Do not step out, but wait for the Holy Spirit. You are supposed to cast out demons. You are supposed to heal the sick. You are supposed to preach the gospel, and you are supposed to teach the word, but do not. You see, he knows that we live in a world that darkness is all over around us. The dark kingdom is fighting the light of God. It's fighting Christianity. John 10:10, he says, the enemy does not come except to steal, to kill, and to destroy. The purpose of evil is to destroy good. And I'm sending you to go and do something good, to save souls, win souls for the kingdom. And the enemy is not happy about that. He wants mankind to go with him into hellfire. So you are going to be opposed. You are going to go through all kinds of challenges. Some of you, if you are not equipped from on high, you are not empowered from high, you will throw in the towel and you will quit the commission. So wait, because I have something special for you. Though I'm not physically here with you, but I'm bringing something, empowerment that is not going to be attached to any other source. The power himself is coming to reside in you, and it will continue to regenerate from within, inside of you. As I'm here, you look up to me. But I'm going. I will not be with you. And I'm bringing something else that is more powerful. I am here with you. You go, you come back and report to me. But the time is coming, you're going to be all over the world. And I'm not going to be at every single place with you. That is why you need the Holy Spirit that will be in you wherever you are all over the world. And that will become the source of generating power right there inside of you. And you will not lack anything. We need the Holy Spirit, church. It is for your advantage that I go. This tells me a few things that I'm learning from this. That number one, believers are going to be oppressed by the dark world. And therefore we need the power of the Holy Spirit. Again, our own abilities, talents, education, willpower, and motivation cannot contend with such powers of darkness. Our own abilities, it can never. Without the Holy Spirit, our strength can never. Our own wisdom can never. We can never stand without the Holy Spirit. Our talent, it cannot. Hallelujah. Again, the Holy Spirit gives power and reveals what God desires to be done. That when we have the Holy Spirit, he directs us, he leads us, he guides us. What should be done at every point in time? We know the will of God because our spirit man communicates with the Spirit of God. So we don't miss the plan of God. We are always guided by him. And anything done or will be done here on earth by God will be through the power and the ministry of the Holy Spirit. If God is going to execute any plan, if God is going to fulfill anything in the life of mankind, if God is going to bring anything to happen in our lives or here on earth, it's going to be by the ministry of the Holy Spirit. God will have to work through people that he has deposited his spirit in them. It is through them he connects and reveal his plans to us. We need this power. Power beyond description. That which comes to quicken us. Which comes to enable us to fulfill our destiny. It was prophesied about him that he will come and save the world. But then he had to wait for the Holy Spirit. And he told the disciples the same, and he's telling you and I the same today. I believe that it is time we need to open our hearts and receive him and welcome him. The Holy Spirit is not just a force. It is not some kind of force or pressure or something from God or from whatever. No, it's a person. The Holy Spirit is a person. Part of the triune God. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. It is for your good that I go, so that he will come and reside in you. With the Holy Spirit, my brother, my sister, nobody can stop you from fulfilling your destiny. Nobody. You need him. You need him. Shall we rise at this time as we pray? Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. If there is anybody here who wants to accept Christ as his or her personal Savior, you want to come forward, I'll pray with you. Because that is the only criteria. That is the only thing that you need. You need to become born again. And then the infilling of the Holy Spirit comes after. So if you want to accept Christ, today is opportunity. You know, there are so many things we dream about. There are so many things that, you know, we desire to do. There are things that we want to do, but we cannot. We need the help of the Holy Spirit to direct and to lead us. We need empowerment to take away the weakness. Sometimes there are some decisions that it takes that courage, that boldness to take that step in life. But you are always hesitant because of the fear of unknown. But when the Spirit of God comes upon you, church, you will make bold decisions. And the Lord will help you. We'll see you through. Fill me and use me, Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Oh, break me, mold me, and mold me, and you. Your hands as you receive and you welcome the Holy Spirit. You are just inviting Him, the Spirit of the Living God. Just take over me, fill me, empower me. Oh, yes, He touched me. Oh, oh, again, He touched me. Maybe somebody, you are here, you have not received the baptism. The Lord is here. If you open up to Him, He will touch your life. He will fill you. The Spirit of God is here to ignite that faith, to rekindle that which is in you, so that your destiny will come alive. He will empower you to walk in dominion. Anointing fall. As you are singing the song, just open up to Him. Just invite Him into your life. Mama yam dada babo. Oh yes, so Lord. Oh, the Holy Ghost. Anointing, anointing. resurrection unto service of the kingdom. Empower us, the spirit of excellence. We need you. We need you. We need you. We need you. Holy Spirit, we need you. Empower us. Somebody just welcome the Holy Spirit. Welcome the Holy Spirit. Just welcome Him into your life. You need the infilling, the refilling, and infilling. You need the fullness of the Spirit of God. He will give you wisdom to do things in a manner that will marvel people. Your area of work, your occupation, when the Holy Spirit comes to fill you, you will receive the spirit of excellence. You will perform extraordinary. Everything about you will change. Everything about you will change. Talk to the Holy Spirit. He's right here in our midst. Where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there. The spirit of the Lord is here. The spirit of the Lord is here. Mayi nanaba kaboshi kebere. Mama yabandorobo. Rebo shikebe abandorobo. Bederebe. Rebo shikabaya dorobo. Rebo shikebe derebo abo kabandore. Darababo. Somebody begin to speak in other language and just speak in the tongues, and the Spirit of God will begin to fill you. Open your mouth, begin to just speak, just begin to pray in the Spirit, in the prayer language. The power of God is here. Oh, Spirit, hallelujah. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You said it is for our advantage that you should go to the Father, and you will send Him the Helper. When He comes, He will convict the world of sin. He is the Comforter, the Teacher. Without Him, we cannot have comfort in life. He is the source of comfort. We need Him, Holy Spirit. With all the discomfort that the curse of life bring upon us, you are our comforter. Come upon us. Give us the comfort. What is killing people, giving them blood pressure and all kinds of things, people going through sleepless night, insomnia, having all kinds of depression and mental problems, because of the curse of this life, Comforter, come into our lives. Calm the storms of life for us. For when you are in our lives, we'll be able to stand it all. We will gain mastery over these issues of life. who will gain control over these issues of power, who will have power over the works of that kingdom all around us. We will fulfill our destinies. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you have heard our prayer. In Jesus' name, shall we lift up our hands? The faithful, the most gracious, the everlasting God, today, your word has come to remind us the need for us to have the fullness of the Spirit. We pray today that by our prayer and our confession, the Spirit of God has come into our lives, touched our lives, filled us one more time, and we would never be the same from this day forward. We have received the empowerment to make bold decisions, take new steps in our lives that will help shape our destinies and our future. That our lives will bring glory to you. And then the power of God that has come upon us will help us to stand at all times. Hold on to the faith. We will not retreat. It does not matter what happens around us. As the apostles stood, we will stand. Amen. We will stand. Amen. We will stand. Amen. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. We are as bold as lion. Amen. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord. Unto him who is able to keep us faultless and present us righteous before his throne of glory. May you watch over us, protect us, our going out and our coming in. Be with us, O Lord. Amen. And wherever we will be, let your spirit also be there with us. Amen. Direct our path, O God, Amen. In all our ways, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Have a good week. God bless you. And we'll see you tomorrow. Have a good day. Thank you.